today in the subject of the operation management, Professor Dr. Manoj Kumar will discuss about the strategy and operations strategy. Objective, relation between the different value elements, competitive strategy, cost leadership strategy, differentiation strategy, focus and niche strategy, some aspects of the general strategy. Today, we'll discuss about these topics of the operation management, the Richardson, Taylor and Gordon framework, technology frontierism, technology exploiter, technology serviceman, customizers, cost minimizing customizers, cost minimizers, translating strategy into operational effectiveness, implementation strategy, summary, keywords, review questions, and further reading. Hence, today, strategy and operation strategy, this is the topic of the production and operation management. The objectives of this study, after studying this unit, you will be able to recognize the competitive capability relationship with operation strategy. Describe the objectives of the competitive operation strategy. Discuss the model developed by the Richardson, Taylor, and Gordon. Explain the implementation of operation strategy. Introduction. Peter Drucker says, the primary task of the strategic management are to understand the environment, define organization goals, identify options, make and implement decisions, and evaluate actual performance. Then, the aim of the strategic analysis is to perform a view on the key factors that will have an effect on the future well-being of the organization. Strategic analysis enables us to identify and understand the potential opportunity and constraints that exist for our organization. It will be enable us to make informed strategic choices about the future of our organization. What opportunity are offered to it, and does it have the capability to take up the opportunity? Relation between the different value elements. Unless the firm's performance metric system is able to measure customer satisfaction, it risks being penny-wise and pound foolish when it comes to measure customer service cost, marketing usage, a concept called the lifetime value of the customer, in which it estimates the stream of income a firm can expect to receive from a satisfied good customer. Timeliness in the value model varies because it is both individual specific and situation specific. Its measure is delivery reliability when the customers are told a product will be delivered on the specific date. The value of the product higher when the promise is kept. Anything less diminishes the value of the firm's product. Delivery reliability also enables the supply chain to operate effectively with lower levels of the inventory. Lastly, improving flexibility can affect the other elements of the value. Flexibility affects lead time and quality through the synergetic relationship among the three elements of the numerator of the value equation. Reduction in lead times affect flexibility, improvement in the flexi benefit, quality, improvements in quality, reduce lead times and enhance flexibility. Now the question is, what is the flexibility? Flexibility is the input to the value equation relating to the ability of the operation management system to give the customer the product desired. All these factors together with productivity and cost improve the company's ability to improve on its competitiveness and profitability. This allows the organization to do many things such as expand its operation and thus create employment and opportunity for employees to advance. Invest in advanced technology and system that will further enhance its productivity. Pay employees better wages and provide them a better working environment, thus raising their work, morale and standard of living, and contribute more to society by paying a higher quantum of the corporate tax and supporting more social cause. Self-assessment. Complexity affects lead time and quality through the synergic relationship among the these elements of the numerator of the delivery. Reliability enables the supply chain to operate effectively with levels of the inventory. Marketing uses a concept called the lifetime value of a customer, in which it estimates a firm can expect to receive from a satisfied good customers. Timeliness in the model varies because it is both individual specific and situation specific. Competitive strategy and objectives have a major impact in determining the different operational parameters at the corporate level. We have discussed some of these in the previous section. However, there are many other factors, and the list may differ from one organization to the next between the different time periods for an organization as well. The principal impact on these parameters come from the competitive advantage, corporate strategy and competitive strategy from a hierarchy of the strategy. Corporate strategy are concerned with the type of the business the organization is in, its overall competitive position, and how the resources of the organization have to be deployed. The business strategy are basically competitive strategy. The objective of this strategy are about how to compete successfully in the particular markets and how can the business units acquire competitive advantage. Sun Tzu, a Chinese strategist and general, made an observation in The Art of the War. The more opportunity that I see, the more opportunity that multiply before me. This phenomena is at the heart of the strategy. Organization competes successfully by seizing opportunity at the business unit level. The strategic decision that the organization need to take is how will it place its product in the marketplace. What will be the basis for it to gain competitive advantage? Organization achieve competitive advantage by providing their customers with what they want or need better or more effectively than competitors, and in ways the competitors find difficult to imitate. The strategy for the each organization is unique, reflecting the particular circumstances it faces. There are two schools of thought on developing competitive strategy. On the one hand, the concept of the generic strategy is promoted by the strategic thinkers like Michael Porter. On the other hand, Prahlad and Hamel promote the resources-based approach. However, we will lay greater emphasis on the generic strategy, as these are industry focused and reflect more closely the requirement of the operation management strategy. In order to succeed in this, organizations have found many offensive and defensive actions to defend their position in the industry and cope with competitive forces. There are two basic types of the competitive advantage a firm can possess: low cost or differentiation. The two basic types of the competitive advantage, combined with the scope of the activity for which a firm seeks to achieve them, lead to three mutually consistent generic competitive strategy. These strategies are cost leadership, differentiation, focus strategy. The third type of the competitive strategy, focus strategy, has two variants: cost focus and differentiation focus. These strategies can be used by organization to outperform competition and defend its position in the industry. The generic competitive strategy are shown in the figure below. These strategy needs to be examined in conjunction with the competitive capability of the organization and the external environment. Effectively implementing any of the generic competitive strategy usually requires total commitment and determined organizational support from the operation management. There needs to be compatibility between corporate level strategy and strategy at the operational level. Competitive scope, narrow target, broad target, cost leadership, differentiation, cost focus, differentiation focus, lower cost, differentiation, competitive advantage. Cost leadership strategy. A firm pursuing a cost leadership strategy attempt to gain competitive advantage primarily by reducing its economic cost below that of its competitor. This policy, once achieved, provide high margins and a superior return on investment. The skills and resources required to be successful in this strategy are sustained capital investment and access to capital, superior process engineering skills, good supervision and motivation of its labor force, product designed for ease in manufacturing and low cost distribution system. The organization attempt to exploit economies of skill by aggressive construction of efficient economies of skill thought. Volume of production and specialized machine, volume of production at cost of plant and equipment, volume of production and employee specialization, volume of production and overhead cost. This strategy requires tight cost control. This is often done by using a full costing method or activity-based costing with frequent and detailed control reports. The structure of the organization should be clear-cut. The responsibility of the clear laid out. Organization often provide incentive based on meeting strict quantitative target, etc. In order to remain a cost leader, a firm attempts to avoid those factors that can cause the economies of scale to be affected. It has to work within the physical limits to efficient size, worker motivation, and focus on markets and the suppliers. Sometimes in restricted geographical area, firms that are known to have successfully used this strategy in number of their businesses include Black and Decker, Texas Instruments, and DuPont. The low-cost producer strategy works best when buyers are large and have significant bargaining power, price competition among rival sellers in a dominant competitive force. The industry product is a standard item readily available from a variety of sellers. There are not many ways to achieve product differentiation that have value to the buyer, and when buyers incur low switching cost in changing from one seller to the another and are prone to shop for the best prices. A low cost leader is in the strongest position to set the floor on market price, and this strategy provides attractive defenses against competitive forces. Its cost position gives it a defense from competitors because its lower cost means that it can still earn returns after its competitors have competed away their profits through the rivalry. It is protected from powerful buyers because buyers can expect powers only to lower prices, and thus will be possible only with the next most efficient competitor. Lower cost provides protection against the supplier because there is more flexibility in the organization to cope with input cost increases. Any new entrant will find it difficult to overcome entry barriers because of scales of economy, and as the activity taken to the achieve low cost are both rare and costly intimate. Finally, it places the organization in a favorable position when pitted against the substitute compared to the competitors in the industry. Cost leadership is valuable if buyers don't buy differentiation very much. Buyers are price sensitive. Competitors will be immediately match lower prices. There are no changes in customer taste, technology, exogenous price, cost. There are a number of risks in using the strategy. These risks relate to the fast changing business environment. The most important risk to the cost leadership is technological change that nullifies past investment or learning of the organization. Sometimes the inability of the management to see or anticipate change required in the product and market change is the risk. The organization advantage can also be neutralized. If there is low cost learning by the industry, newcomers inflation in cost of the supply or process that provides the organization a competitive advantage.